Hello, and welcome to the July edition of Sparrow News. I'm Barb Baker. 9-year-old Brendan Scott was so badly injured when he was hit by a car in December that few thought he would survive even a few hours. The Sparrow teamwork and expertise that saved him left even longtime hospital veterans awestruck. Medical staff from various specialties recently gathered to discuss the case and celebrate their achievement, and they were thanked by a special guest.
I was shocked. I mean, we knew that there was a lot of people in and out of the OR with him that night, but to see them all in one room is a little overwhelming to realize that that's what it took to save him.
We had so many people that were involved in the most critical aspects of what happened with this boy. The number of people that were here, it was as high as it was because they understood the significance of this. We had anesthesia, we had surgeons, we had the OR crew, and it might have been the first time that they were all in the same room all together. And to be able to tell this story, to be able to pay these kind of compliments, to be able to acknowledge the kind of teamwork that it took to save his life, this was a celebration.
Dr. Gruten getting emotional during that. You could tell that his heart was there and brings it closer to us because we know how much their heart is in what they do. If their heart wasn't in it, we wouldn't have the results that we do. From less than 1% chance to this, in just shy of 6 months, that he's back this far.
For the people who are in an OR, or in an ER, or in a PICU, or on a rehab service, quality takes place one patient at a time. And this was a celebration of quality as high as it can get.
We thank the incredible Sparrow caregivers who went above and beyond to provide quality, compassionate, and life-saving care to Brendan. Sparrow recently unveiled a groundbreaking new campaign, For Health, For Care, For Life. The phrase epitomizes the commitment of our caregivers who are the very foundation of Sparrow. Chief Medical and Quality Officer, Dr. Karen Kent Van Gorder, explains.
For Health, For Care, For Life really takes into account what our caregivers understand to be their calling. We take care of patients and families throughout the life cycle when they're healthy, when they need care, and we understand that our health care really plays out in our whole community and everybody's life. Sparrow caregivers really honor their commitment to the community. We're friends and neighbors and family members taking care of our friends and neighbors and family members. The care at Sparrow is personal. It's the kind of care you would want for your sister or your brother, your father or your mother, your neighbor, your best friend.
For more information, go to sparrowhealth.net. Jill Barnes of Lansing was crippled by pain, and no one seemed able to help her. After seeing Dr. Michelle Becker of Sparrow Medical Group OBGYN, she ran her first marathon last fall and says her life has been changed. Barnes discusses how Becker simply listening to her helped resolve her issues.
I had been having several medical issues. I was conducting interviews one day for a potential employee and I had a seizure during the middle of it. I had had a seizure in front of my mother, which was a horrible, horrible experience. I was scared. I didn't know what was happening. Dr. Becker took time with me. She sat down with me and actually listened to my story and asked questions.
And I think that's an important part of what we do is to really listen to how things are affecting a patient's life. And I think that's where Jill comes into play because I really did listen to how this affected her daily life and her work and her family life. And so when she came to me with that information, it just made sense to me to perform the hysterectomy. But I also knew accomplishing that with Da Vinci would get her back to her life and back to what she needed to do on a day-to-day basis.
So explain what the Da Vinci robot is to me and how it benefits you.
So Da Vinci is a robot, and even though they call it robotic, it's not like I push a button and someone else does, the robot does the surgery. I'm in full control. It's more like a remote-controlled robotic device. And my face is inside the optics. It's like I'm inside the woman's belly, and it's just the best view. And I think why we all fell in love with the concept of Da Vinci was for the patient outcomes. They tend to recover more quickly. They get back to life more easily. And that's what we all want, if we do have to incur surgery, is to get back to our life more quickly.
I literally went from having a few seizures in a month to I haven't had any in almost a year now. I had always had on my bucket list to run a full marathon, and it was time. I really felt like I had had my life back. I was Jill again, and I had a sense of empowerment after the procedure and after the medical issue that at this point I could accomplish anything. And I did. I accomplished a marathon. I mean, how many people out there can say that they did that?
For more information on SMG-OBGYN, go to sparrow.org/sparrowcarson. Sparrow Hospital has earned an A for patient safety in a scorecard of 2,600 hospitals nationwide, reflecting the hospital's commitment to quality and safety and meeting the needs of every patient, every time. Safety Officer Jeff Kay explains what that means for our patients.
The Leapfrog Hospital Safety Score, the letter grade, is a great vehicle for patients to be able to go to their website, look up a specific hospital or hospitals. It allows you to compare right on their website different hospitals and see what hospitals' strengths are. And so when you go to that website, you can look up potentially the procedures that you may be having, and it'll help you see how the hospital fares from safety and quality standpoint. So they'll look at the rates that you might have for different infection types, for the communication of physicians and nurses and other staff. We are a magnet hospital at Sparrow. That gives us extra scoring in that, because to be a magnet hospital, you have to comply with many different things that lead to quality and safe patient care.
To see Sparrow's full score and access consumer-friendly tips for patients and loved ones visiting the hospital, visit hospitalsafetyscore.org. Sparrow Medical Group recently opened a new orthopedics and sports medicine practice featuring fellowship-trained physicians who are experts in joint care. One of them is Dr. Matthew Dubiel, who had a fellowship at the Mayo Clinic where he learned shoulder and elbow treatment from the top specialist in the world.
I'm one of three orthopedic surgeons hired by Sparrow at this time. Personally, I'm a shoulder and elbow upper extremity reconstructive surgeon. There's two other doctors in the practice who are sports medicine doctors who treat many different sports injuries. It's an interesting joint to work on. It's a shoulder and elbow and upper extremity. There's not a lot of people who have my background in training. Some people do sports and they work on the shoulder. Some people do joint replacements, they work on the shoulder, but not many people really just do shoulder and elbow surgery. So it's a nice niche to be in. The technology in shoulder arthroplasty is advancing, and it's exciting and very interesting. The patients do really well with shoulder replacements. The complications are really low, and patients can walk home in a sling.
Carrie Mowat of Sparrow Physicians Health Plan said she was floored when she learned she had been selected as this month's Caregiver Spotlight. Carrie is known for spending countless hours arranging services for patients, and colleagues say she's more than deserving of recognition. What does a nurse case manager do?
Well, a nurse case manager meets with patients and we identify some complex health needs that they might have. We want to make sure that our members get all of their medications that they need. Then we make sure that all those authorizations get in place here at the insurance company so that their care needs are being met.
Why did you get into healthcare, and how did your journey lead you here?
I think it was just who I was meant to be. I guess it speaks to my soul a little bit. It feels really good to be able to help people, especially in their times of need. Even here at the insurance company, it's the care component that I value the most. And looking at how we can help meet our members' healthcare needs in general. And I like the high touch that physician health plan case managers have. We get to know them fairly well, especially somebody that has complex healthcare needs that we've been working with for a long time.
How do you feel about being named Caregiver Spotlight for this month?
I was very humbled and touched. It made me feel proud of what I do here at PHP. It made me feel like we are making a difference.
Tell me a specific account with a relationship with a member that stands out to you.
I had a member that I had worked really close with for a long period of time, and we had never been able to meet one another because she was at an outlying hospital. When we were able to get her transitioned here locally, we kind of joked and she said, I told my friend that I was going to meet you. And I said, of course you are, because I'm going to come and see you as soon as you get to this area. And I found out that week it was her birthday, so I figured that's the perfect time to go and visit her. So I left here at PHP, and on my way home, I stopped and picked up an inspirational magnet for her with an inspirational saying on it, and took it to her on her birthday. It was a great visit. Those visits with our members and when you're seeing them amongst their family, you can really learn a lot about what their needs are and how you can facilitate and help them. So that visit with that member on her birthday was super important to me, and I know that she valued it as well.
To nominate someone for our Caregiver Spotlight, check the nomination form at the bottom of the Daily Sparrow Newsbreak. That wraps up this edition of Sparrow News. Thanks for watching, and be sure to tune in next time when we bring you more news from Sparrow.